This is an IPS screen, and in today's video, I'll show you how to use this powerful display with an Arduino. More specifically, we'll be working with a model that features the ST7789 controller. But what does that mean? Well, unlike I2C-based displays that only have 4 pins, this screen has 8 pins because it uses a different communication protocol called SPI. And that is actually a huge advantage. SPI displays are significantly faster than their I2C counterparts, making them perfect for real-time applications like animations, data visualization, and even simple games. So if you are interested in learning how to use the ST7789 screens, stay tuned because I'll teach you everything you need to know to connect, code, and control them with Arduino. And at the end, you'll build a good project to apply everything we've learned today. Are you ready? Let's get started! If you've been experimenting with Arduino, you've probably realized how important it is to display data, whether it is sensor readings, system status, or graphics. There are a few ways to do this, like using LCD screens or IPS displays. Today, we'll focus on IPS technology, specifically the ST7789-based screens with 8 pins. So why choose this screen? The IPS technology gives you better colors, wider view angles, and faster refresh rates compared to standard LCDs. And because it uses SPI instead of I2C, it can transfer data at a much higher speed. The I2C display uses two wires, SCL and SDA. It's great for connecting multiple devices, but is slower due to the limited bandwidth. On the other hand, the SPI display uses four main wires, SCL, SDA, plus CS and DC. It's much faster, making it ideal for screens where performance matters. Now that you understand the benefits, let's break down the pin connection so you can get the screen working with Arduino. For this tutorial, I'll be using an Arduino Nano, but you can follow along with any Arduino board to connect the ST7789 display properly. Use the following wiring setup. To make things clearer, you can use this pinout table. Once the wiring is complete, open the Arduino IDE and upload the script Hello World. You can find the code in the GitHub repository, link in the description. After uploading, your screen should display something like this. Now you may be wondering, what is that staying on my screen? Well, I accidentally damaged my display by handling it incorrectly. It left this permanent mark, but thankfully it is still functional enough for the tutorial. Just a reminder, handle these screens carefully. Alright, let's break down how the code works. Let's take a look at Hello World. The first part of the script includes three important libraries to control the screen and enable SPI communication. If you don't have these libraries installed, open the library manager, search for them, install them, and then re-upload the code. Next, we define the ship select, reset, and data command pins. These are crucial for SPI communication. Then we create a display object which allows us to send commands and graphics to the screen. Inside the setup function, we initialize communication with the display, set display parameters including resolution, rotation, background color, and text properties, print a message on the screen. If you want to change the text color, for example, simply replace white with green or any other color. Upload the code and now we have green text. Need bigger text? Change 2 to 3, upload again, and boom, larger text. Now that we've got the basics down, let's use the display in a real-world project. Let's take things a step further by adding a DHT11 sensor to display temperature and humidity on the screen. Here's the updated wiring diagram. Before we upload the new script, temp and humidity, let's break it down. The structure is similar to the previous script. First, we import libraries for both the screen and the DHT sensor. Then, we define pins and create objects for the both devices. In setup, we initialize everything similar to what we did in the previous script. Then, on the loop function, the board reads the sensor values and chooses colors dynamically according to this table. Additionally, the display alternates between Celsius and Fahrenheit every 2 seconds. Once uploaded, you should see real-time temperature and humidity updates. And that's it for today's tutorial. Now you know how to connect an ST7789 display to an Arduino, understand the difference between I2C and SPA, control text, colors and graphics, and know how to build a temperature and humidity monitor. If this tutorial helped you, consider liking the video and subscribing for more hands-on Arduino projects. If you enjoyed this video, you'll love this next one, where I teach you how to use ultrasonic sensors with Arduino and build a simple alarm system. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.